Come on up the hill to the cradle of forestry. We got a real nice place here amongst the trees. History, nature, science, what more do you need? Forest-inspired nature discovery.
Come in! Hey!
Clay.
Hey, Stephanie, how are you?
I'm great!
Glad you could make it. Just finishing up the soup, it should be ready. What you got?
I brought some stuff to go with the soup.
Yeah.
I've got some bread and butter.
Excellent. I love bread and butter. What is that? What did you bring?
A bread and butter. Oh, it looks different from yours because I bought it at the store rather than like making it.
What is that?
That's butter.
Why is it in this weird shape?
Well, because I bought it from the store.
It's a weird color, too. Somebody needs to check on that cow. I don't know if it's doing okay. This is what our butter looks like. It's not really in a certain shape, and it's pretty soft. I just made this morning.
You made that?
Absolutely. You want to show you how to?
I would love that.
Definitely. All right, so we have the tools that we need for making butter here at the house. First thing we need is the pail, so that we can go out to the cow and milk the cow, usually in the morning and the evening. And that's a job that we all share, because we can all do that. And then once we have the milk in the pail and it separates, and the fatty cream separates onto the top, and we pour that into the butter churn. And this is the tool that actually makes the butter. And you might have seen this before, and this is the paddle that goes up and down, and with the cream inside, you just agitate that cream inside.
Agitate, meaning to stir up or just disturb.
Yeah. And since we only need a little bit, we're going to be using this mason jar to agitate.
Agitate.
So here we got some of that cream, and it's in the jar. And what we're doing to agitate, is we're shaking it. And it is really nice to have some help around when you got to do that, because it takes a good 10 or 15 minutes of shaking it to be able to get that separation. All right, so now we have been shaking it for about 15 minutes, and if you can see that, we've got the solids making kind of a ball in the middle, and there's some liquid that we're gonna drain off. So I'm just gonna use this cheesecloth, and I'm gonna pour that liquid off, and what's gonna be left behind is my butter.
Oh, okay.
There it is. And just to help with its storage, we're also gonna rinse it a little bit with some water. I'm gonna drain that one more time. And now we have our butter. Well, we got our butter.
It looks great, and we know through modern science that it went through a physical change. The liquid cream turned into a solid butter, and then it can go back to a liquid if you melt the butter. That's pretty neat. Understand that?
Well, that sounds like some of the scientific learning they're doing over at Dr. Shank's Biltmore Forest School. I don't know much about that, but I do know that in the spring, the butter tastes different than it does in the fall because of what's growing and what the cows can eat.
Wow. Our butter just tastes the same all the time because it comes from lots of different cows.
You don't own your own cow?
No. My butter comes from a factory.
That's not what we do.
Yeah, well, you didn't have factories like that back then in the late 1800s.
Hmm.
Well, here we are ready to try our butter.
All right.
Mmm. It's so much sweeter than my butter.
I've got a real good cow.
You too.
Yeah, what do you think? You want to start making butter at your house?
Wow, well, this was fun, but I don't have room for my own cow. And it's a lot of work. I do like the convenience of going to the grocery store, but I could see doing this with friends and special family occasions. Here's what you need to do, make your own butter at home. You need heavy whipping cream. You need a jar that can seal. You need a cheesecloth or some sort of strainer like this. And you need some water and, of course, a towel because you will make a bit of a mess. And this lasts in the fridge for about a week. So enjoy.